Ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon. Come to York, Mr. George Perris. One Voice Radio. I'm your host, Kenneth Hieber, and with me today, the incomparable George Perris, who, as you know, is no stranger to our show. It's such a great day here in New York City today. The air is crisp out, and it's clean. The skies are a beautiful blue. What a great way to spend an afternoon. Great company, great music, and of course, all of you listening to us from all around the world, a very, very warm welcome to you. Well, George Perris has done it just yet again, a brand new CD live. If you've not heard the tracks yet, you need to get ready to be transported on a magical musical journey, because we're going to be playing tracks from the new album, some oldies that we've all come to love, some of his just recently released French album, and knowing me the way you do by now, there are, of course, a few surprises up my sleeve, too. And remember then, will you, that George will be taking your calls live on the air today, and 10 lucky callers will receive, with his love, a personally autographed copy of George Perris Live. Once we're ready to open up the studio lines, we'll let you know, and then call us in. And you can go onto the Facebook page for today's events and pop in your comments. Let us know what you think of the show. So settle back, get comfortable. We're all in for the most magical, magical time with fantastic music. And, of course, as always, the amazing George Perris being his warm, charming self. Let's get to it, George. How are you today? You're looking extremely good.
Hello, Kenneth. Good evening. I'm very, very happy. I'm good. It's Christmas time, so it can't be better than that.
Absolutely not. I totally agree with you. Love Brazil. Love it that it's on the album.
I'm glad you love it. It's it's a fun song, and fun is always useful, and it's always nice to, you know, when you have fun and you really have fun and it's straight from the heart and it's real, then it's only a good thing. It can't be a bad thing.
Very definitely. I agree with that. And I just, from the moment I heard you perform that, I fell in love with that song and thought, what a way to open. It's incredible. It just brings such a good vibe to what I know is going to be a terrific show.
Thank you.
George Perris Live is out. It's available. We've talked about this before. What's the excitement level like? It must be really high for you, because my goodness, you've done so incredibly well this year. But how does it feel now that this last baby is out for the year now?
I'm very, very excited. You know, we worked very hard for this record. I've been working on this record for more than a year, actually. So I'm so happy that it's finally out. And I keep receiving messages from all the fans that have already listened to the record, how much they love it. So I'm super happy. I'm very excited. I really am. You have no idea.
Two albums in 1 year. That's incredible stuff. I'm extremely proud of you.
It's a little crazy.
You swear that I'm kind of your producer. Oh, I think you've done brilliantly this year, George. It's so great to have you with me today. You know, this is, as I told you, the last show of One Voice Radio for 2012. So to end it off with you is an extremely high note in my radio show career, which has been fantastic to date. So thank you for taking the time. I'm so very, very happy to see
you. It's
a
great honor for me, and thank you for inviting me, and thank you for wanting to do this show with me. You know, it's always a pleasure to be here with you and to speak about everything that we've done in the last few months. It's always a great joy, and I consider you a great friend, and thank you for having me.
It's my absolute pleasure. Thank you for being here. Let's take a break and listen to something. I'm thinking, I'm going to go with something that I can hopefully pronounce. George, what about...
Go on, I want to hear you pronounce the Greek title. I really want to hear you do that.
No, you know, as far as I'm going to go is Je suis malade, if that is...
That's not Greek.
I know, but you're not going to get much more Greek out of me. I can say a few Greek words, but certainly not on the air.
I'm going to teach you how to pronounce titles.
Thank you, George. Let's take a break and listen to Je suis malade, which is off the live album. It's beautiful. Listen, we'll be right back.
Je ne rêve plus, je ne fume plus. Même plus d'histoire. Je suis laid sans toi, je suis sale sans toi, comme un orphelin dans un dortoir. Je n'ai plus envie de vivre ma vie. Ma vie, elle cesse quand tu pars. Je n'ai plus de vie, et même mon lit se transforme en quai de gare. Tu t'en vas, je suis malade, complètement malade, comme quand ma mère sortait le soir et qu'elle me laissait seule avec mon désespoir. Je suis malade, parfaitement malade. Jamais quand tu pars, on ne sait jamais d'où, et ça va faire bientôt 2 ans que tu t'en fous comme un rocher, comme un péché. Je suis accroché à toi, je suis fatigué, je suis épuisé. Là, je bois toutes les nuits et tous les whiskies pour moi ont le même goût, et tous les bateaux portent ton drapeau. Je ne sais plus où aller, tu es partout. Je suis malade, complètement malade. Je verse mon sang dans ton corps et je suis comme un oiseau mort. Toi tu dors, je suis malade, parfaitement malade. Tu m'as privé de tous mes chants, tu m'as vidé de tous mes mots. Pourtant, moi j'avais du talent avant ta peau. Cet amour. Je crèverai seul avec moi, près de ma radio, comme un gosse idiot, en écoutant ma propre voix qui qui chantera. Je suis malade, complètement malade, comme quand ma mère sortait le soir et qu'elle me laissait seule avec mon désespoir. Je suis malade, c'est ça, je suis malade. Tu m'as privé de tous mes chants, tu m'as vidé de tous mes mots, et j'ai le cœur complètement malade, cerné de barricades. Ton temps, je suis malade.
And rightly so, George. What a spectacular, spectacular performance. Always. I love the stuff you do and the way you put your heart into everything that you do, you know. It's just, it's really, really incredible. Listen to this. Heather from South Africa says, enjoy it, both of you. Unfortunately, it's bedtime for me, but I will listen on demand. So, folks, those of you who cannot hear us today because of your sleeping time, don't be concerned. You know that you can catch us on demand once we're done here today. And, of course, we fly into the Apple iTunes store also. Philip from Brooklyn in New York says, I'll be here listening, too, to another great show of One Voice Radio. Welcome, Philip. It's so glad to have you here. Comments going all over the show, George. People are sending messages. Walfred from Mexico says, greetings from Mexico, dear friends. What a great entrance. And, of course, that was Brazil. What, I mean, that really got the mood going. And Nas says, hi, Ken and George. A big hello from France. So we have so many people listening to us from all over the show. It's kind of fun, isn't it?
I'm so happy. I'm so touched that our friends are listening to us. It's a great joy. It really is
indeed. It most certainly is. Eliana says, we will join you. Have a great time. And Eva sends a huge heart to you. Clark, another New Yorker, Clark, also says, dear Kenneth, please wish George Perris the very, very best of the holiday season from me. So with all of those wonderful messages and more to come, tell me this, George, how do you summarize your year, if you possibly even could, because it's been such an action-packed year for you, and you've done so much, you've accomplished so much. It's just been fantastic. How do you summarize?
It's been a great year. It's been a beautiful year. It's been busy, creative, crazy, romantic, beautiful, insane sometimes as well. But it has been a great year. It has been a wonderful year. I've had the chance to travel a lot, sing a lot, record a lot. It has been a wonderful year. I met new fans, mainly in Canada, with the tour that we just did and the French record that was released there. It was a beautiful, beautiful year for me. I have many great memories from 2012, and I can't wait for 2013. I think it's going to be an even better year. But yeah, it was a little crazy. There were a few periods during this year that were a little insane. Mainly last, when was it? It was in February and March, where I had to wake up every day at 7 o'clock in the morning or 8. By 10, I was at the studio in Athens. Till 10 o'clock at night, I would work on the live album. And then as soon as I would go back home, I was Skyping and working on my computer till 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning because we were finishing the French record at the same time. So I was working for approximately 18 to 19 hours a day for a whole month. It was crazy, but it was worth it. And in the end, I really had a great time.
Well, then answer this question. How do you look so amazingly well and so well rested after working 18-hour days?
Trust me, I am not well rested. I'm looking forward to next Tuesday and onwards for at least 10 days, I'm not going to be doing anything. I'm going to get some rest. I think I deserve it now.
I do. I absolutely do think so. Hey, George, listen, you've got a year coming up ahead of you, too. You should take cues from this. Gabriella in Romania says, I am so glad for his beautiful career. I'm sure George will go higher and higher, and maybe someday he will come to Romania. Thank you.
I would love to come.
So there's an invitation, but next one up is Birgit, who says, it's a joy to see George become better each year. I would love to see him come to Germany and perform. People want you all over the world. There's a little bit that wants you all over the show. Angela from here in the United States says, please tell George what a pleasure it was to see him perform on November the 17th here in New York. I loved his voice, and I wish him a world of success. And so they go on and on and on, which is fantastic. George, you bring so much joy to so many people that I think...
Oh, if only you knew how much joy my friends bring to me. You know very well that I call all my fans, they're my friends. And
absolutely.
If only they knew, I wish they will know how much joy and happiness they bring to my life.
Well, as do you to many, many, many around the world. George, let's take a little break. And here's the problem I have, please. You really have got to introduce the next song.
Oh, it's going to be a Greek one. Yes, let's play a Greek song. It's
okay.
Called "I Balanda ton Estision ke ton Parestision," which basically means the ballad of all your emotions and all your, let's say, hallucinations.
Aha! Uh-huh. Thank you for helping me out with it. Here it is.
And
look,
it's a
I'm
song,
not even.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
It's a song. What I was going to say. It's a song that by Manos Hadzidakis, who is. Our most important composer here in Greece. Unfortunately, he passed away a few years ago, but he is responsible for some of the most beautiful, beautiful music that has ever been written here in Greece. And it was a real honor for me to sing his songs. And I was very happy because his son, who is responsible for all his father's music, he actually gave us the permission to record the song with a lot of enthusiasm and many, many great words. So I was really happy to include it on the record.
Wonderful. Here it is, live then, off the new George Perris live album. Listen to this. We'll be right back and we'll take some more of your messages. Thanks for being with us.
Σαν παλιό σινεμά και σαν τη χάλιμα που μιλάει με τα παιδιά σου κρύβω την αλήθεια και αφήνω από τα στήθια μου να βγουν παραμύθια για εκείνους που αγαπούν. Για στιγμές μυστικές, για λάμψεις μαγικές, για αγκαλιές ερωτικές, για νύχτες φωτεινές. Σαν παλιό σινεμά και σαν τη χάλιμα που μιλάει με τα παιδιά σου κρύβω την αλήθεια κι αφήνω από τα στήθια μου να βγουν παραμύθια για εκείνους που αγαπούν. Για στιγμές μυστικές, για λάμψεις μαγικές, για αγκαλιές ερωτικές, για νύχτες φωτεινές. Για αγκαλιές ερωτικές, για νύχτες φωτεινές.
Bravo, George. That is terrific. What a lovely performance that is. Fun to sing, though, huh?
Oh, thank you. Thank you. It is a little hard to sing, but it's a very emotional song, above
yeah.
all. And it has beautiful, beautiful lyrics, because at some point what it says is, now I stand naked in front of you, and I look like a god, and I'm in your hands. You can love me. You can bring light to me. And my body is just the only way I can reach to you. So it's, you know, one of the most beautiful songs ever written in our country, and I'm really happy to sing it.
I have to say that I think that the thought that goes into Greek music and Greek poetry is just sensational. Oh, Greek music and poetry are kind of the same thing in my mind. You know, just
yeah.
beautiful, beautiful, heartfelt lyrics with music. It just is absolutely amazing. George, Carlotta writes, she says, I was introduced to your, she's writing to you, she says, I was introduced to your voice through Kenneth Hieber, and I simply loved it. And I've been following your work ever since and sharing your talent with friends from Monterrey in Mexico. Feet on the ground,
oh,
my dear George. Feet on the ground, my dear George, for I foresee a wonderful future for you. And un beso cuerdo, George. Mwah! I guess that means one huge kiss for you. And that comes from Carlotta in Monterrey in Mexico.
Un abrazo.
Terrific. Aha, there you go. Go on, go on. That's terrific. George, you've done so many terrific performances this year. Anything stick out in your mind that you think, yeah, that was good. I like that. I'm really, really pleased with it.
Quite a few of them. Quite a few of them. For sure, as I go backwards, I did a very special concert in April in Cyprus, which was dedicated to French music. So it was
yeah.
Beautiful for me and very important, because I came back to my roots, if you want, to all the great French or French-speaking composers and singers like Edith Piaf and Jacques Brel and Charles Aznavour and all the major, huge French artists that, you know, I was raised with them. So it was very important for me to do that show. A few months later, we did, of course, the concert with the Boston Pops in June. I was a guest of Mario Frangoulis. And, you know, playing with the Boston Pops was an amazing experience. And, of course, singing with Mario is always a great pleasure. He's a great friend of mine, and we always have an amazing time. And at that concert, it was really fantastic, because three other friends of mine were there, Alkesis Protopsalti, Haley Westenra, and Stefan Mokio. We're all very, very good friends. So, you know, it was a wonderful experience. The orchestra was amazing. The venue was beautiful. And we repeated almost the same concert a few months later at the Herod Atticus Theater in Athens under the Acropolis. And that, I can tell you, that was one of the most important moments in my life, because I have dreamt of that theater ever since I was a little kid. When I was 4 years old, I saw Nana Mouskouri, who is my all-time idol, perform in that theater. And that's, if you want, when I started realizing that I wanted to be a singer, that's what I wanted to do. And in any case, it's one of the most sacred theaters in the whole world. It's been there for more than 2,000 years. And just the thought of singing in front of almost 5,000 people and having a full moon, because we had a full moon that night.
Oh, my goodness.
And the Acropolis on top of us was just, it was just magnificent. It's one of these memories that I will never, ever forget. And
almost,
of course,
surreal, isn't it, when you think about it?
Yes,
it's almost surreal.
Listen,
I do have to pick up, I've got to pick a bone with you, though. You said you
yeah.
were in Boston with Mario and three of your other friends. Excuse me, are you not forgetting something?
Oh, you were there, of course.
Thank you, George.
We're actually a lot of friends. A few of my very good friends were there, so it was a wonderful. It was a wonderful evening that night.
Oh.
And of course, you know, since you asked me about great moments, my tour in Canada was a wonderful, wonderful experience. Especially the last concert in Montreal. A lot of people were there. I felt a lot of love coming to me from these people, because because, you know, the Canadians are an amazing group of people, especially the les Québécois, as we call them, because they are simple, kind-hearted, genuine people, and I really felt their love surrounding me, and it was an amazing, amazing experience. All the concerts of the tour were great, but that final one in Montreal was very emotional. It was an unbelievable experience. Now that I think about it, I'm quite touched to remember these memories. It was a great, great month.
We need to go back and talk about Canada, because the last time you kind of teased me, you told me that it was going to be different, and I tried to get it out of you as how different, and you said no. And, of course, I was unfortunately not able to make it. So I'm going to cross-question you when you come back. But I have a few messages, and then we'll take a music break again. And why don't we open the lines and give away some CDs? What do you think?
Sure, with pleasure.
We do that? Well, listen to this. Paul, down in Sydney, Australia, says, nice to be able to hear you at this time. And, of course, there tomorrow already. We're on, what day of the week is it, George? It's Tuesday, isn't it? Wednesday? I think it's Wednesday.
I've lost track of time. It's Wednesday.
And Paul from Sydney writes, it's great to hear us, and there they already on Thursday morning. And Georgia says, Kenneth, I'm enjoying your show, and thank you for introducing me to George Perris. His Greek song was beautiful, and Manos Hadjidakis is my idol. And a word she ends off with, which you taught me, philakia.
Ah.
Yes, you see, I speak Greek.
That philakia is the code word. Between my fans and I, it's a word that we all use together, and now I think that they all know that philakia means kisses in Greek. And
I know,
and
we all need to do it.
It's very funny, actually, because in Canada, a few of the fans were telling me that now they start sending philakias to each other, not even just to me. So we've created a monster.
You have. I've even started to do that myself nowadays. I end off things with philakia. it's crazy, but hey, you've created a whole. See, you've created a whole new trend. Look at you; you are a trendsetter without question. George, I think we should do a couple of little giveaway kind of things. What do you think?
Sure. Anything
okay.
You want.
Let's do that, folks. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up our studio lines in just a second. We're going to, of course, take a break and listen to a piece of music. And when we come back, then we'll start taking some calls. You can call us. Our studio lines are now open, and we're at 619-639-4749. Again, that number is 619-639-4749. And this way you can express your wishes to George Perris directly in person. Cast a Spell comes up next. Stay with us. Give us a call. We're here, and we're having an enormous amount of fun, as you can well see.
Skimming stones across the sea, the perfect number is what I need to cast a spell. Changing all the world, it's time to take a chance. I see angels dancing in my wishing well. I'm going to change the world. Spirits are moving through the air. Heart beating fast without a care. This is what life is for. Of my fate, I'm trapped inside the maze. Forgotten ways of yesterday, I wish away. New steps to create. Spirits are moving through the air. Hearts beating fast without a care. This is what life is for.
let me tell you this. Cast a Spell could not have been more appropriate right there, because we got a caller in on the line, and I could see it was an international number, and lifted the call, and it was our friend Jackie phoning from Germany. She was listening to the show by way of a handheld device, and she wanted to give her message to George, so she let her bus go. She called from the bus station, and she couldn't wait to come on the air because she had to go off and catch the next bus, which was sort of right behind it. But Jackie, for phoning all the way from Germany, what a sweetheart. It's a thrill. Remember, please let us have your mailing address, and we'll get a very personalized, signed, autographed CD of George Perris live to you in a very just in a couple of days. Next caller coming up on the line. Tell us who you are, where you're calling from.
Hello.
Who's this?
Hi, this is Peggy.
Hello, Peggy.
Oklahoma.
Peggy,
hi,
from
how
Oklahoma.
Are you, Dan?
How are you?
Hi, George. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you, too. Merry Christmas.
I'm so
We're
glad that you joined
there.
The
Only
show today.
5 days left.
Yes. Yes, not long. I was just calling in to, first of all, I wanted to thank you very much for your beautiful performance in St. Louis. I was there for the show, and I just enjoyed your show very much and meeting you afterwards.
Thank you. Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And I wanted to thank you for taking the time to meet with us after the show.
Oh, of course. It's my greatest pleasure. I enjoy that even more than the concert itself. I can tell
yes,
you that for sure.
Yes, it was very nice. And my question for you is, well, you had already answered one of the questions that I was going to ask. I was going to ask you how old you were when you discovered your love of music.
I was three, four.
Yes, Good and form. You mentioned that. but my other question is, what was the first performance that you did before a live audience, and how old were you?
I was 11 years old. It's very funny that you mentioned this. I was 11 years old in Greece, and a very good friend of mine actually made me take part in a singing competition, and I sang my favorite song. It still is my favorite song. It's called Hartino to Fegaraki. It's another beautiful song by Manos Hadzidakis. And it was the first time that I went in front of a few people and I sang. And it was very good because I actually won. So it was
Oh, you did
experience.
Well. That's wonderful.
I think
that
if I had lost, I would have never sung ever again.
And so were you nervous?
Oh, very. I'm always nervous, you know. Every time I have to do a concert, an interview, every time I have to meet someone, or I'm recording in the studio, it always is. I'm always very, very nervous. And, you know, my legs are shaking. It's a little crazy, especially before a show, a few minutes before the show. I'm like, you know, it's a little scary sometimes.
You know what?
I'll tell you, it doesn't show.
I have to tell you this, that I think a dose of nervous energy for any performer before any show is a very good thing, because you'll always be on your toes and you will always give your very, very best performance, because you strive for that incredible success of what it is that you do. So nervousness is good. Peggy, thanks so much for calling in. If you'll message us, please message me into my personal message box. A mailing address, and we'll make sure that you get a CD autographed on its way to you in a very, very short space of time. That was Peggy calling in. Thank you very much. We've got another caller on the line now as well. Hi, who's this, and where are you calling from?
Hi, it's Barbie.
It's Barbie. Hello, Barbie. You're live on One Voice Radio. Talk to George.
Hi, George.
Hi, Barbie. Είμαι καλά. Εσύ είσαι καλά?
Πολύ καλά, ευχαριστώ πολύ. Φιλάκια από μένα.
Oh, φιλάκια πολλά. See the word, see Kenneth, see how everybody uses φιλάκια.
I know. I wonder how many languages Barbie actually speaks. Barbie, you amaze me. You just, I mean, you're like a, are you the originator of Google Translate, perhaps?
No, I know a few words of many languages, but not many, just about 35, just a few words of each.
Mm.
Yeah. Un abbraccio, molte forte.
Bobby, nice of you to call in. A message for George from you for the holidays. What would that be, dear?
Well, I wrote down a few questions.
Oh, you did?
Yep, mm-hmm. I'm all good here. Is George ready?
All right, let's rush through them. We've got quite a full call, so go with your first one.
Okay, first of all, how many hours do you practice singing each day, and do you practice every day?
Yes, it's almost every day, and I do practice at least an hour or an hour and a half. Sometimes I don't because, for example, when I have to perform, I will only warm up my voice before the concert for about 20 minutes, and that will be it. But when I'm not performing or not recording, I will always work on my voice every single day. I have to do all my exercises, or I will go to my vocal teacher, who's an amazing lady here in Greece. She's a soprano, a classical singer, and she's always very strict with me, but she, you know, if you see all the booklets of all my albums, there's always a little thank you note, especially for her, because she made me love my instrument more than anyone else, and I owe her a lot.
That's beautiful. That's really wonderful. My next question is, when you have a performance, and the show must go on, and you get a cold or a sore throat, how do you treat your throat because you have to perform?
Well, you know, most of the times when you have a good technique, even if you're sick, even if you're not feeling well, you will be able to do a show. It might not be 150% of yourself because, unfortunately, your body can't follow. But you will be able to do a show and put all your emotion into it. Of course, you know, I drink a lot of tea and I take a few some pills if I have to, but you know, I always try to take care of myself before the shows so that that won't happen. It actually happened. It was very funny. It happened 4 years ago. I was doing a series of shows in Greece, in Athens, for three consecutive Fridays, and I was ill for three whole weeks. But I was able to do the shows, and they went quite well.
Perfect, Sherman. Bobby, and your last question, love.
Yes. This is the most important question. So be prepared. What is your favorite flavor of ice cream?
Oh, I know. I'm going to sound pretty boring, but it's simple vanilla. That's my vanilla. It's my favorite. It's my favorite ice cream. I could have tons of it. But only if I'm on tour. If I'm performing, I can't.
Well, now we all know George Perris likes vanilla ice cream and lots and lots and lots of it, and of course not while he's performing. Bobby, I'm so glad you called in. Pop us an address for you into my personal mailbox if you would, sweetheart, and we'll get to have George autograph a copy of George Perris Live and get it in the mail to you ASAP. So glad you called in, and here's something. George, as you know, we saw one another in St. Louis and in Boston, but there was one song that I just couldn't stop, and I couldn't stop, and I couldn't stop talking about over and over and over. It so happened, of course, in St. Louis, I was snugly tucked away in the front row between these two last ladies who just called, beautiful Peggy and beautiful Barbie, and together we enjoyed you singing Maria. We're going to take a break and listen to that. Call us if you'd like, folks. We're open at 619-639-4749. But in the meanwhile, listen to this piece of music that I have been going on and on and on about. It is exquisite. It's Maria.
Let me tell you before you put it on.
Sempre io cantavo a lei. cuore mio ti porterò per sempre io cari cavalier vedeva già il suo destino.
The audience applauses. George, I've told you 100 times that when you performed that and I saw you perform that the first time, I took off like a rocket out of my chair. It was incredible. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little about that song.
Well, first of all, let me say a big, big thank you to Mario Frangoulis, who actually sent it to me today. It's the first time that anybody's hearing the song, because it will be on the DVD. The live DVD that Mario is releasing with the Boston Pops, I think it is released in the next 3 or 4 days or something like that. It was a great moment for me, even though, remember last time I had told you, I was a little bit hesitant at first to sing this song. I thought I wasn't going to be capable of doing it. But in the end, it turned out to be beautiful, and we sang it a few more times. So I'm very happy. It was a beautiful moment.
Enormously proud of you for doing that, because really it was absolutely terrific. I've not stopped talking about it. Thank you for letting us play it here on One Voice today for the first time. My goodness, that is an absolute honor. Thank you to you, and of course thank you also to Mario. Dear George, I would like to say that this album met all my expectations. Great song choices with your amazing voice. I really loved it very, very much. Also, I'd like to mention that I'm so happy to see that our friend Niece Eden, of her beautiful photographs that she took at your concert in Turkey, that you put them in the booklet of this great album. George, thank you so much for sharing. She goes on to say, George, thank you so much for sharing your beautiful voice and music with us. I wish you all the success you deserve with this beautiful album. So looking forward to seeing you again in Turkey and or in Greece. Much love to you always. And that comes from Arzu in Bursa in Turkey.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. And let me thank Nessa from my heart for giving me these photographs. Some of them were really, really beautiful, and it's an honor to have them on my record, and I'm very thankful to her.
And she's a brilliant photographer, huh?
Yes.
Love. I've seen some of her stuff. Mary writes, and she says, I hope I can listen in. Not quite sure that she could. Of course, she can listen to the on-demand version, but she does say, I would just like to wish George a very, very Merry Christmas and to let him know how much I enjoyed his last interview with you and his beautiful music. And, of course, Walfred pops in again from Mexico and says, wishing him all the best, dear Ken, and please ask him about his next performances and or shows in the States. I guess I'm not going to get that out of you today, am I? You're tight-lipped today. You're not giving away anything, but I'm sure 2013 we're going to see much more of you here on this side of the Atlantic, aren't we?
I think so, too. I can't...
No, you don't have to say anything.
It's very funny because on one hand, I want to tell you everything, and then on the other hand, I can't.
Absolutely. Well, you know what? George, when you can is when you'll come back, and then we'll address all of those questions. Walfred, on the other hand, I'm sure that we're going to see George here in the United States or in Canada, or, hey, let's all just go to Mexico and have a big fiesta and sing songs and have a good time.
Let's say that it's a promise. You'll see a little more of me this year and especially the year after that on that side of the Atlantic.
Fantastic. And Kim from Toronto says, please send my love from Toronto in Canada. Tell him that I love him so and I appreciate him sharing his gift with us all. Kim, thank you for all of those notes. Everybody, thanks for your notes. Trying to get most of them that I'm seeing that are being popped up. Nath writes one more thing. She says, I love your version of Je suis malade. A big heart, wonderful, all of my compliments. Arzu as well. Bravo, after we aired Je suis malade. So, George, this album is fantastic, man. It really is just so, I don't know, it's so kind of nice. And you know, if one thinks that I am being totally biased at this point, if you think it's just me who's singing praises here and who is thinking how fantastic George is and reading all of these amazing messages, I happened to catch up with someone who you'll know in a second, and I asked her what her opinion was on George, and guess what she said. And again, much applause, George. Wasn't that a little surprise? Divulge who that is.
Where did you find that? I would recognize that voice. In my sleep, in the middle of the sea, in the middle of the sky, I would recognize that voice. It's Lara, of course. My beautiful Lara Fabian that I adore. How come
wonderful?
I don't have that? Where did you find that?
I was talking to her, and I said, hey, give me a Christmas song. And she said, for you, anything. I'm just kidding you. No, of course not. But it was, hey, where I find my stuff. You know, George, what can I say? We've got to do what we've got to do to make good music and good vibes and so on. And as I was trying to say a little earlier, one may think that perhaps I'm biased by always glowing about how amazing I think you are. And then this is what
I love George Perris. I think he's a great performer, a great singer, very young and so talented yet. And I couldn't believe the phrasing and the musical qualities that he had translating my songs, and the fact that singing in Greek gives it a complete different feel and still is so faithful, so true to the original emotion. And he's a great, great talent. I'm really happy to share something with him.
Laura, beautifully said. So let's let him play let's let him sing another beautiful piece of music to us. And we'll be right back after this.
Je serre les poings un peu plus fort. À défaut de serrer ton corps, je regarde passer en silence les ombres de l'absence que j'ai apprivoisée. Et perdu au sein de ma transe, je suis la table où repose ton alliance. Ancré dans mes souvenirs flous, je prie comme on s'en fout, comment voudrais crever. Dis-moi comment t'aimer au-delà du départ, entre ce vide immense et l'histoire que la vie vide de sens. Dis-moi comment rester au-delà de ce mal qui vient de t'emporter et que rien n'aura fait dépaler. Pas même tout l'amour du monde qu'on s'est donné. Tu étais belle comme un désir. Ta vie était le plus grand des navires. Tu transportais le monde entier dans un sourire immense qui s'éteint à jamais. Dis-moi comment t'aimer au-delà du départ, entre ce vide immense et l'histoire que la vie vide de sens. Dis-moi comment rester au-delà de ce mal qui vient de t'emporter et que rien n'aura fait détaler, pas même tout l'amour du monde. Donné. Je te garde vivant en secret. Et quand je chante, j'entends ta voix résonner. Dis-moi comment t'aimer au-delà du départ, entre ce vide immense et l'histoire que la vie vit de sens. Dis-moi comment rester
au-delà de ce mal. Rien ici ne nous rassemble. J'ai juré que nous serions ensemble pour l'éternité. Mon ange, je viens te
George, that is really, honestly, so, so beautiful. And of course, Lara is such a lovely testament to the beginning of all of that. We have a caller on the line for you, George. Hello, caller. Welcome to One Voice Radio. Tell us who you are and where you're calling from.
Hello, this is Diane from the state of Washington.
Hello,
hi, George.
Hi, Diane.
Again.
How are you?
Hi, I'm good. I just wanted to say hello and, George, to wish you the best on your new live CD. I got my copy last week, the day after Arzu did in Turkey, and I've been playing it ever since. It is just beautiful, and I wish you much success on it.
Thank you so much. So, thank you so
you're
much.
You're welcome.
Have a great
and
holiday.
And I'm looking forward. Oh, you too. Yes, I'm looking forward to seeing you next year. And have a great holiday yourself. And take care.
Thank you. You take care as well.
Diane, lovely to have you call in. A very happy holiday to you, too. Thank you so,
thank
so
you,
much
Ken.
For calling
thank
in.
Thank you.
It's wonderful
right,
to
you
have
so
you with us. Thanks, indeed.
Thank
Diane,
you.
What a lovely person, George. She's just always so supportive and kind and caring. We get on so well. Really, really nice lady.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Yeah. George, tell us now, of course, I need some of the inside scoop, would you please? Because I want to know... as I said, I never made it to Canada. I was unable to get there. However, you said it was going to be very different, and you wouldn't. You refused. And no matter how hard I pleaded and whined and carried on, you refused to give me any inside scoop. So now that it's all over, I want another deal. Tell me. Please.
Well, listen, we had a lot of fun, first of all, because for this show, I wanted to sing, you know, because... You know me, I love all the ballads and all the big songs. I love doing those. But and I always have difficulty in choosing the up-tempo songs, the fun songs on a show. And so for this particular show, I put a lot of thought into it. And so we chose 3-4 songs that were up-tempo, and we had a lot of fun. I made the audience sing with me. There was a lot of partying during that concert. Also, we had a couple of stories, if you want, a couple of sketches with a few members of my band. And before I presented a Greek song called Tritos Stefani, I would say the story of this young woman and basically what the song was saying. And during the first concert, for some reason, one of my musicians made fun of me. And it was actually on stage. So it was so funny that we actually kept it, and we kept it going for the other concerts. And we had a lot of fun. Of course, I sang a lot of many, many songs from the French album. I did a couple of Greek songs. I did a few English songs that I love. I basically did 2 songs from West Side Story. I did Something's Coming and Somewhere. You know, that I always end my shows with Somewhere because it's the hymn to hope, so hope is the most important thing. I did Broken Vow, which is another song that I adore. And I prepared also a small surprise for all my Canadian friends, and I sang a traditional Canadian song that is called Un Canadien Errant. And it was a very particular moment because it was my last encore during each show, and it was a very... very emotional moment. I saw a lot of people crying, especially in Montreal. A lot of people were crying in the audience, so it was a beautiful, beautiful moment. The good news is that pretty soon you will be able to see a few of the videos from the concert because we filmed and recorded the last concert in Montreal. So we will be uploading a few songs from the concert.
Oh, that's going to be awesome. And tell me, so the audiences really, they were very receptive. I know I saw a lot of fantastic photography as well, you know. A lot of pictures popped up and appeared all over the show. That was a thrill, I'm sure. Because that was, remember when we had quite a laugh the last time around before that, and this was going to be your big boy moment, as your mom put it. You were going out on your own, your big boy moment now.
And you know what? I'm going to tell you a thing, but don't make fun of me.
Okay.
You know, I was going on and on how it was going to be my big boy moment. And then in the end, I called my mother and she came with me on tour. Because I didn't want to be very lonely. So I brought her with me from Greece and she did the whole tour with me. So it turns out I wasn't such a very big boy. I had to have my mother with me.
Well, you know what? No, I'm not going to make fun of you because I think it was, first of all, I think it was awesome that your mom came. How terrific to have her there just as a support structure. But
She did. She made the trip. She came at the other end of the world and it was a lot of fun.
Bless her. That's fantastic. And I'm sure she got to have a lot of fun watching you perform. And then, of course, doing fun activities like sightseeing and so on during the day.
Yes. Well, we didn't get the chance to do a lot of that together. She had to do it on her own because I was, you know, closed up in my apartment, not going out and protecting my voice. But she saw a lot of Canada. And I was very happy because she loved Canada as much as I did. It's a country that I really, really love.
Fantastic. George, I want to take a break and just tell our audience, our listeners, that this album now that we're talking of, George Perris Live, if you go to our show page on Blog Talk Radio, the One Voice from Africa as it's shown there, you're going to be able to see the record cover. Now, all you need to do is click straight through to that, and you'll be able to go and buy the MP3 download format via Amazon Worldwide. It's an international release. Also, if you look in the text above where we referred to George and the conversation of today, you will be able to click on his name and go to his website. Or if you click on the album George Perris Live, you'll also be taken to websites where you can go and buy your own copy right now. And I think that you can tell with this incredibly exquisite, exquisite music and just his warmth always, you really want to own a copy. And you know what? Christmas is just a few days away, so please get it as soon as possible. Listen to this. It makes me choke up. I'm sure that if Jacques Brel was a year of this performance of Ne Me Quitte Pas, he too would choke up. Enjoy this. We'll be right back.
Ne me quitte pas. Il faut oublier tout. Peut s'oublier. Qui s'enfuit déjà. Oubliez le temps des malentendus, le temps perdu à savoir comment. Oubliez ces heures qui tuaient parfois, à coup de pourquoi, le cœur du bonheur. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Moi, je t'offrirai des perles de pluie venues de pays où il ne pleut pas. Je creuserai la terre jusqu'après ma mort pour couvrir ton corps doré de lumière. Je ferai un domaine où l'amour sera roi, où l'amour sera loi. Où tu seras réel. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Ne me quitte pas, je t'inventerai des mots insensés que tu comprendras. Je te parlerai de ces amants-là qui m'ont vu deux fois. Je te raconterai l'histoire de ce roi mort de n'avoir pas pu
te rencontrer. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. On a vu souvent rejaillir le feu de l'ancien volcan qu'on croyait trop vieux. Il est, paraît-il, des terres brûlées dans nos pluies de blé qu'un meilleur avril. Et quand vient le soir, pour qu'un ciel flamboie le rouge et le noir, ne s'épouse-t-il pas? Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas. Je ne vais plus pleurer, je ne vais plus parler, je me cacherai là à te regarder danser, sourire, à t'écouter chanter puis rire. Laisse-moi devenir l'ombre de ton ombre, l'ombre de ta main, l'ombre de ton chien. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas.
George, that is incredibly beautiful. You know, that is a song that is so well known and so revered around the world. It just, and your rendition of that is, it's heartfelt. It's very, very, very heartfelt.
Thank you.
How did that make its way onto the live album? Is that something you like to perform on stage?
Yes, it's actually one of the first songs in French that I ever learned, because Jacques Brel was my mother's favorite singer, and we would have all of his records at home, and I've always loved that song, and I've been singing it ever since I was 18, 19 years old. And of course, at the time, even though I loved it for reasons that I don't really know, I couldn't, I wasn't mature enough
right.
to sing the meaning of that song. And now, 10 years later, and, you know, after having my share of love and separations and everything that comes with a relationship, I felt the need to sing it, and I sang it a couple of years ago, and that recording is from, it's from a concert in Canada. Actually, it was a concert in Greece. That was from a concert in Athens that I did 2 years ago, and that's what the recording it comes from.
Mm. It's exquisite. George, are you familiar with the entire work known as Jacques Brel is Alive and Well and Living in Paris?
Yes, actually. And a very good friend of mine gave me a DVD of that show, and I saw it last year, I think. It was beautiful. It was beautiful. And so,
brilliant, isn't it?
So creative, yeah.
Yeah, the whole thing. It's in its simplicity, it's so wonderfully, wonderfully creative. I love that.
Yes,
I love it.
It is.
It's often on here in New York, and I try and see it as often as possible. It just, oh man, I love it. Absolutely, and I love the way you perform that. George, a highlight from me was seeing you in St. Louis, of course, as we know, and you sang alongside such a very, very, very beautiful, beautiful lady. Tell us about that.
It's my Deborula. That's how I called her, with a heavy Greek accent. I put on my heavy Greek accent, and I say my Deborula, which means my little Debbie. I love Deborah. She's a great friend of mine. I met her, of course, through Mario. Mario Frangoulis introduced us, and we instantly became very good friends. And I love her voice. I think she has such a great quality to her voice and the emotion she puts into her singing. And she can make the most difficult classical aria sound like a song that you've always known. Which, and to me, that's a very important thing. And singing with her is always a great pleasure. And I look forward to being on stage with her soon.
She is really quite remarkable. When she came out and did an aria on her own, and she just stood there in this beautiful red gown and just belted, my goodness, I thought, that's wow. It was breathtaking. Some more messages. A lot of things have popped up again. Jenny Butler down in Durban, South Africa says, I'm here, I've joined you, enjoying it. Barbie is talking back and forth. And Joanne from Boston wanted to say hi to George and wish you happy holidays, and also wanted to tell you how much she enjoyed seeing you in June at Symphony Hall. You were absolutely amazing, she says. Diana says, I love the mum story. Excellent show. George's voice is so smooth, so beautiful. George, let's listen to you doing something with Deborah. What about All Alone Am I? Can we do that?
Oh, of course. I love it.
Sounds fantastic. Here again from the live album, George Perris and Deborah Myers. All Alone Am I.
All alone am I, ever since your goodbye. All alone with just the beat of my heart. People all around, but I don't hear a sound. Just alone.
Λόγο στο λόγο και ξεχαστήκαμε. Μας πήρε ο πόνος και νυχτωθήκαμε. Σβήσε το δάκρυ με το μαντήρι σου. Να πιω τον ήλιο μέσα απ' τα χείλη σου. Σβήσε το δάκρυ με το μαντήλι σου. Να πιω τον ήλιο μέσα απ' τα χείλη σου. Λα 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 λα.
People all around, but I don't hear a sound. Just the
Deborah Myers. George, it's kind of coming to the end of our time together, which I really don't want to... I don't want that to happen. So should we just talk slower so that we can spend more time? I'm just kidding you. No, it's been... What a wonderful way of spending an afternoon here. It's terrific. Here's a song that I love off of George Perris Live. It's track number 8. Tell me a little more about that, would you?
Oh, well, only if you can pronounce the Greek title.
If I can pronounce...
Let's see. Can you do it?
Can I do it? All right, let me put myself on a limb. I'm going to say it's to gramma.
Oh, very well. To gramma, yes. So this
I tried.
Actually, it was very good. Very good. Caristo, well
George.
Done.
Caristo. Thank you.
Oh, para caro. This is actually one of my very, very, very favorite songs from my repertoire in Greek. It was originally sung by Lara Fabian in French, and I translated it and wrote the Greek lyrics to it, and it was in my second Greek album back in 2008, Perlonasa, and I wrote it during a very difficult phase I was going through. I was going through a very tough separation, and I basically needed I needed some comfort, and that's how that song came into my mind. And up today, I try to sing it as often as I can. When I do my own shows in Greece, especially, I always include it in my shows.
It's a very special, heartfelt memory to you of a period that you were living in your life, George. Beautiful piece of music, really, really is lovely. And that first album, Perno Arnasa, that you were talking about, that still rocks my world, I must tell you. I love that album from the moment I heard it. Let's take a break and listen to Togramma. And when we come back, let's start with our final wrap-up of thoughts. We sadly do have to, we have to stop. I don't want to, but we have to. But let's take a break and listen to Togramma. George Perris, right here with me on One Voice Radio Live. And we're coming to you from New York City today. Remember, folks, go off to our Blog Talk Radio webpage, and there you can see the record cover of the brand new album. Give it a click, and you'll go straight through to where you can order your own copy online. And also, if you look through the text which describes today's show, if you click on George, on the name George Perris, you'll be able to go straight to George's personal website. And also, if you click on George Perris Live, you'll be able to order the hard copy of the album if that's what you prefer, as opposed to having an MP3 format type album. But let's go to Togramma, a special dedication from me to someone who's always done so much for me in my life. All the way on the other side of the world with love. Here it is. George and I will be back.
Écris-moi une lettre de rupture en m'expliquant toutes les raisons qui t'ont fait évanouir dans la nature, qui me font mélanger toutes les saisons. Choisis bien tes mots, choisis les justes. Comme un artisan prend son temps quand il ajuste. Écris-moi une lettre de rupture. Envoie-moi seulement le brouillon. Promis, je vais rien chercher dans les ratures. Écris-moi une lettre au crayon. Écris-moi comment on écrit la musique. Sacrifie-moi au Dieu des amours à mes yeux. Même si partir qu'on ça fait du mal au sentiment, ça peut quand même faire un beau geste, sauf si bien sûr l'un d'être ment. Rappelez-moi γράμμα διακοπής. Γράψε μου πρώτα αφού το σκεφτείς. Μην κρύψεις τίποτα, μη φοβηθείς. Διάλεξε τις λέξεις αν θες. Να παίρνω χωρίς τις σιώπες που σε έκανα να κλαις. Κρυφά χωρίς να μου το λες. Εξήγησε μου πως τελειώσαν οι δρόμοι που είχαν λογική. Φωνή και εικόνες με προδώσαν στη μνήμη που είχαμε.
George?
Hello.
How do you say the word exquisite in Greek?
Exeretiko.
Thank you for helping me out once again. That is, say it again, that song is beautiful.
Exeretiko.
Exeretiko. Stunning, stunning. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful piece of music. That is so, so incredible.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's... It touches the heart, it touches the soul, it touches every emotion. Very, very well done. What a beautiful performance. And that must be, I think it must be difficult to be able to perform that on stage as well with an emotion that goes with it, you know? Because you don't have to get up and sing a song. I can get up and sing a song. But you guys with these incredible talents and the amazing performers you are, you put everything you have into it. And I can feel that in that piece of music. I don't want to give away all of the songs now on the live album because people need to go out and get this. Folks, it's available now worldwide by Amazon.com. You can get the MP3 download format. Click on the show page and get yourself this album. You need it. And you know what the bad news of all of this? It's almost Christmas Day, and someone you love needs the hard copy CD in their Christmas stocking. So go click on George Perris Live on our show page and order your rush copy if you want to have the hard copy of the CD, which I'm sure you probably do. It is gorgeous. George, let's talk about one more thing, and then we'll start wrapping up. I want to – let's see how in tune you and I are. I want to listen to something from the French album. Just because I love that, French album so much. So I'm going to ask you to pick the song, and we'll listen to it, and then we'll come back and we'll do our closing remarks, because
ooh,
I would love to.
I have to pick the song?
Would you? Yeah.
Well, listen, you know, it's very tough for me to choose one, because I love all of them.
Okay, well, think.
But you know what? Listen, let's pick a song, actually, that it comes to my mind, because one of the main things that I did this last year was to travel a lot. And the title of that song is Voyager, which means to travel. So
talk
let's
about
play that
NSYNC.
One.
Talk about NSYNC. Here it is, folks. Voyager, meaning to travel. When we come back, George and I will start our closing remarks. It's been wonderful spending time with you today. Sadly, though, we need to come to a close. But listen to this brilliant piece of music. We'll be back with you in just a moment.
dormir, maman. Je vais naviguer au vent, des voiles attraperont l'instant, des rires blonds et des enfants. Dans la brise ou les tempêtes, dans les brumes de ma tête, quand tout redevient un tourment. Je vais naviguer au vent, cap sur les ports et les gens, sur l'amour itinérant. Voyager à 7 milliards d'étrangers pour aller de tristesse à beauté. Voyager à 7 milliards d'humains pour aller de tendresse à plus loin. Au milieu de tous ces yeux, dans leurs horizons si bleus, tant qu'il y aura du feu, je vais naviguer pour eux, mes voiles gonflées de leurs vœux, peu m'importera leur dieu. Dans la brise ou les tempêtes, en ces attentats trop bêtes, dans un monde d'aboiement, je vais naviguer encore de l'Europe au Labrador. Vous aimez toujours plus fort. Voyager à 7 milliards d'étrangers pour aller de tristesse à beauté. Voyager à 7 milliards d'humains pour aller. Voyager
favorites, George. There's something about the ballad in that magnificent piece of music which just also touches every one of my senses. Such a beautiful, beautiful piece of music. I go back to the chat board and I look and see what's going on while you're performing so beautifully. And every single next word is Philakia, Philakia. And it says kisses all around. Clearly, everybody's having a fantastic time, and I have had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful afternoon with you. Peggy's even going back and forth saying, I didn't have an opportunity to tell you what a fantastic stage presence you have. You are a natural performer. Philakia. Thank you for starting.
Oh, see, there you go. Everybody says Philakia. I'm so happy. It makes me really happy.
Absolutely. George, it's been a wonderful, wonderful afternoon. So many messages, so little time. It's sad, but we have to say goodbye now. And I know, and I can
see... Oh, we do already?
Yeah, look, you know, we've been going at you for an hour and a half, which is a long time. And somebody popped a little notice, like we're having our own private concert, they said, listening in. So, yeah, I feel that it has been that way, because it's just great to hear you. It's great to hear your heart. It's great to hear your music. It's great to hear your success. It's just great. It's all great. And I recall, George, do you remember our first interview together was... It's almost 2 years ago when you think about it. It's about 18 months ago. And it was when you released Humana. That's how it all started. That's how you and I became acquainted. And from there, well, as they say, the rest is history. But, George, to everybody that's been listening in so graciously, as we know from around the world, we started down in Brazil, and then we just went whizzing around the globe. And so many people listening in with all of their wonderful comments and their remarks and their love and their joy. With the holidays coming up, your wishes to all of your fans, which you call friends, which is such a lovely thing to do, what kind of message would you share with them for the celebrations of the season coming up and, of course, particularly for the next year that lies ahead of us?
Well, first of all, let me tell you that Christmas is my favorite time of the year. I literally... transform myself into a four-year-old kid running around like a maniac.
That's wonderful. I love that spirit.
I love Christmas, and ever since I was a kid, it was, you know, the magic of Christmas is something else. So I'd like to wish everyone to enjoy the holidays, have a great, great time. Never forget to, you know, cherish the child in them and remember that sometimes we really need to let go of all our problems, all our anxieties, and everything that makes us sad or in any case causes trouble. And remember that we need to be naive and innocent like children. And now Christmas is the best time. And I like to wish everyone to happiness. May you all be happy and safe. And above all, remember to love and to be loved, because love is the only source of peace. It's the only true proof of intelligence, if you want. It's profound and it's endless. And if we all learned how to love each other a little more, I think we would be living right now in an ideal planet. So that's my hope and my wish for 2013, a little more love and understanding.
What a beautiful wish, George Perris, for everything that you mean in my life, for the friendship that we share, for all the laughs that we've had and all of the beautiful music I've listened to and all of the conversations back and forth, for the joy you've brought to my life, for the love you've brought to my life, and the kindness, and in addition to all of this incredible music, thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart to you for an absolutely wonderful friendship. Folks, that, I'm afraid, brings us to the close of our show this afternoon, going into the evening. George Perris has been the most amazing guest, and in my opinion, this has been just the most incredible way to end One Voice Radio's 2012 broadcasts. So to everyone who's been a guest on the show and has contributed to the success of One Voice Radio all the way through 2012, thank you so very, very much. To my friends who've come out of the shadows and into the sunlight to talk from their hearts, to them, I offer my sincerest gratitude. But most importantly, to you, our listeners from around the world, thank you. Thank you so much, because if it were not for you, this show would not have existed. So please know you're also very, very loved and very appreciated. And as we draw to a close this evening, I want to wish each and every single one of you listening in today the most wonderful holiday season. To you and your friends and your families, be blessed always. And may 2013 bring you an abundance of peace and enormous amounts of joy. When we come back in the new year in 2013, we have many other beautiful things to talk about, and my first guest of 2013 is going to be Mario Frangoulis. So stay tuned for all of those details coming up soon. You know only too well that I will keep you informed every single step of the way. Folks, I'm Kenneth Hieber. Thank you for listening. And as we leave the air today, as I always say to you, go out there and do your best. And as I always say too, it may not be the best, but it's your best, and that's what's important. As we leave, I do want to dedicate one little piece of music to two ladies who have changed my life for good. Thank you for listening. Good evening from New York City. Here's George Perris performing from his live album, Somewhere.
Halfway there, hold my hand, and I'll tell.